camera. One more time. There we go, people. I'm gonna post it right now if you want to see yourself. I'm at John L. Cooper on Instagram. Check it out. Oh, that guy was blinking down there. Let me take another one for him. You know what? We are living in a time, culturally, where people are just into everything. Do you know what I mean? Like if I said, I want to start an organization today to raise money so my dog can marry another dog. Or whatever, you know, my dog could get married, or for like only natural organic food for my hamster. People would be like, yes, I love it. Right? We're living in a time where people are into everything. And I don't know about you, but what that makes me think is this. That means it is the best time to be passionate for Jesus. It is the best time to stand up for what we believe in. Because Jesus is not a fad. Do you know what I mean when I say that? Do you hear me? Jesus is not a fad. Right? We don't live for Jesus because it's cool. That's not why we live for Jesus. We don't live for Jesus because our friends are doing it. We don't live for Jesus because our parents want us to go to, you know, Sunday school as a kid and things like that. That's not why we live for Jesus. We live for Jesus because we believe that He is the one true God of the universe. We believe that He watches over the whole world and He is in control. We worship God because He is worthy to be worshipped, not because someone else told us to do it. And here in America, if you want to live for Jesus and be passionate about Him right now in America, probably the most you will ever suffer for Jesus' name is that some of your friends might make fun of you. And I don't know about you, but I think it's time that we just say, who cares what they have to say? It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. There are people in the world today giving their lives for Jesus, imprisoned for Jesus, lose their jobs for Jesus. Who cares if your friend makes fun of you on Facebook? It's not worth it. The Bible says this, I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. I don't know about you, but I am excited about meeting lots and lots of young people like all of you guys here tonight. I'm excited about seeing people say, you know what, I don't care what it costs me. I don't care what Twitter has to say and my friends on Facebook. I don't care what they say in the locker room at cheerleading practice. I don't care what Hollywood tells me I have to do. I don't care what the celebrities tell me what I have to do. All that I want to do is see Jesus lifted high and glorified in my life, in my generation. And it is time, because here's what I want to say, being that the world is so, I just think people are into anything you want to do, people, yeah, go for it, it's awesome. But you know what people do actually hate is hypocrisy.
Yep.
We know that, right? So if you meet a friend at your school and he's like, I'm all vegan and meat is murder, and you see him eating a steak, you're going to be like, what's up, right? That's kind of weird. I think it's weird not to eat a hamburger, but that's just me. Oh, I'm joking. Well, I'm not joking. I don't think it's weird, but I love a cheeseburger. Seriously, it's on one, like, you know. I'm on death row, and I get my final meal. I want a huge cheeseburger, and I want a Culver's Sunday. And I'm going to eat it all up. I think I'm straight off topic. Ooh, I got hungry talking about that story. I love it. Going back to my point before cheeseburgers and sundaes, I think it's time that as Christians don't just stand up for Jesus. I think it's time that we actually live for Jesus. Right? I think it's time that we begin to act like all the things that we say. That we begin to love people. I believe it's time that we begin to say, you know what? Compromise is not cool with me. Yeah? Because a lot of us Christians, we can get together with our friends and stuff, and we can go, hey, we really love Jesus, so since I love Jesus, since you love Jesus, we can compromise a little bit, and it's not really that big of a deal. I think it's time that we start loving Jesus more than we love ourselves. Loving Jesus, no matter what it costs us. I am excited to see a generation live for Christ. Excited to see a generation say, I am not ashamed that Jesus is my hero! Just another kill.